Hey, hello, how's it going? Welcome to another Aces and Adventure video. It's been a little while since I did my last video, I think like a week-ish or so. But, you know, hey, I still want to play the game. It's pretty cool. I did enjoy the first video of it, so let's get back in here. Now, I will say, this opening menu, it looks great. I don't know what I'm looking at, though. I don't love that. Let's go over here. Let's see what this tree is. I have available level. Okay. I don't know what I'm looking... Rogue? We want to level up our rogue tree? Yeah, apparently that puts the juice in the rogue tree, I guess. I don't know. Begin the adventure with one additional ability in hand. Achievement progress. Rogue 1 out of 30. This thing's at 30 levels? Oh, no. Apparently I had a second one. Oh no, I have not. I do not. I have insufficient mana to grow a new leaf. Okay, so that's daunting. I'll be honest. I guess we're hopefully gonna play rogue for our next game. I guess let's see what's over here too before we get into it. This is maybe like the bestiary. Okay, this is Magnor. That was the warrior we played before, and this is Shaylin. Who, yeah, seems to be a rogue of some kind. A little bit of a deck construction here, it looks like. I'm not going to mess with this too much because I don't really know the game that well yet. So let's just leave that as is here. And let's hop in and hopefully we can play the rogue. And I didn't waste that level up, apparently, that we got before. Oh. So we did... This is the run we did last time. Well, I guess we can pick our... these are locked. Okay. Well, I mean, we just leveled up the rogue. We might as well play him, right? Contract. Play our starter deck and let's get in there. Oh, you know what? When we leveled up, we might have unlocked a new card that we now just didn't add to our deck, which is unfortunate.
Afraid to enter, a faint orange glow feeds crumbs to your starving eyes.
I don't remember what happened in the story last time. There
was no storm outside.
Like an oracle told us to like go somewhere. I think. I remember that. I remember eating some human meat.
Strange silhouettes serpentine around stalagmites. Eyeless creatures with crude weapons fleeing from something in the depths. This time, surprise is on your side.
Oh, cool. Okay. Neat. So we're killing something that's running away. So. What? Two... Man, okay, so let me see what the surprised thing does. Can I see that? I don't remember how to look at that. Maybe we can left click. I think we'll just automatically win it. Oh, hold on. Enemies with surprise begin the encounter tapped. What does tapped mean? Is Magic the Gathering? What is that? I don't know what that means either. So this here. Okay. I remember this is how it works, that you can the cost is these two cards, so it would automatically get rid of our two and our three. Okay. Async abilities can be used at any time, however, they will not interrupt the flow of combat like a reaction would. Okay. Dual wield gain an additional attack. That's kind of neat. I imagine oh, you know what? Maybe tapped is that they lose two defense. It looks like they're losing two defense when you hover over them. You know what? Let's do this first. We've got some big numbers here. When you deal attack damage with a heart, deal damage or heal damage equal to that damage. So we don't need this. We can't use that really. Grant wild range +1 to a card in your hand until end of turn. So we can like adjust it by one. So if we needed it to be like a straight, we could be like, you know, this can go to a 3, or I guess this can go to an ace, right? Because when you lower it to 1, it's an ace now instead, I assume. Let's attack you. Sure. Let's do another attack, and let's try to kill this guy before they get a chance to respond. Son of a bitch. We will, I guess, end our turn here.
You are not fit to fight my shadow.
A lot of thirsting fangs, which I don't love. let's start with an attack on you. Maybe a little overkill there, but we kill one of them now, which is good. And we will. I'm okay to toss this. You know what? Can we get rid of these thirsting like fangs? These seem so bad. Not even so bad, but just bad in this first fight. They're probably gonna be really good later, honestly. Okay. We keep plinking in for one here. So they're attacking us, which I don't love. We'll just throw a six here and take the damage. That's okay. You're coming in with a nine. We will draw you. Although, actually, you know what? Here's what we're going to do. We're going to defend with the queen, right? So we deal damage back. And then we're going to Thieves' Tools. Although, this is a reaction. So how do reactions work? Can that be used? Or can it be used right after their condition is met? Okay, so let's. These tool are 9, so it can be a little bit stronger, so it can be a 10 if we need it. We attack. Either one. Doesn't really matter, hopefully. Son of a bitch. Okay, you know what? Round 2. Once again, these tool. Kill this MF-er. We win. And then we can Thirsting Fang to heal a bit. Apparently we can use them all, which is very funny to me. Okay, very cool. And now we end our turn. And we win on defense here. Doesn't matter what we use, I suppose, but yeah. Okay. No technique. So our last character didn't have reactions, which are kind of like, they're interesting to me at least, I don't know. Okay, Assassin, we don't have, you know, we can't choose the other ones here. So we'll take this. Seems like a pretty good trait for us.
A blast of sulfur fills the cave with deadly heat.
Oh, it's a dang old Balrog, dude.
Drips orange as it cools from the passage of something hot enough to walk through stone. You throw yourself into an opening to escape the heat.
Okay.
You plunge through a shaft of smooth stone cut by squares of light, sliding for minutes before you're ejected into a cavernous hall.
Neat.
Whoever gouged the stone from the mountain's belly left columns standing like ribs. Rivulets of fire flow between the seams in the stone, no thicker than a hair, pulsing into the chamber ahead.
Weird.
Pitiful figures shamble from behind the pillars. Perhaps once human, but long ago. The color has been taken from their flesh, and their hands gnarled into permanent grips around weapons with still glowing runes.
Well, I need to pause the recording for 1 second. I'll be right back. Okay, hello, I'm back. There we go. We're in like some sort of weird dwarven ancient city, it looks like. I got some weird little dudes. They're dwellers. Okay. Reanimate. What does that mean? No, sorry, I want to look at you. No, I didn't want to do this. Okay, well. Oh, that was not intentional, but okay, sure. What does this do? Oh.
Not enough cards.
Oh, I don't have enough spades. Oh, I needed specifically a spade. Okay, that's unfortunate. Whatever. I'm sure this will kill. It'll be fine. See, look at that. Easy peasy. I was just trying to look at what the ability did. Oh, it comes back once. Okay. Understood. You're coming at me with an ace? Okay. Well, you can have my 3. How about that? And you're coming with an 8, so We'll just give him the 9.
Surrender, and this will be painless.
So, if we kill with this queen, we can trigger Thirsting Fang here and heal back up to full. So then we do that first. What does this do? I didn't even read this. Remove a card from an enemy's hand. Okay. Player Thirsting Fang, heal back up the full. And then... we just get a free damage there. He reanimates, and then we can attack an additional time. With our Joker. And we can just... let me remove, thank you. We win the fight, there you go, cool.
The power.
Very cool. Loot the husks or level up. I'll just use a level up. That sounds more consistently strong. This sword seems weird.
My technique yet improves.
Critical chance. Top deck a jack or higher to deal double attack damage. Oh, so when you do the when you do any attacks, you just get to look at the top card, and if it's a jack or higher, you deal damage, it looks like.
In the chamber beyond,
seems neat.
Dwells a mural of a banquet. From the vantage of a plate at the end of a long table, at the other end, a pair of eyes,
okay,
like two
Hello.
Stars in a black sky, attend the feast.
Hi, how's it going?
Beyond
Fancy meeting you here.
The mural is a statue of a drake with jaws frozen in complaint. There is something in its mouth. Encased in glass.
Like an orb? I would like the orb, please.
A masterwork of articulated brass hovers in a sphere of glass, clasped delicately.
I will take the gauntlet. The drake's teeth. I accept the gauntlet, please. Oh, reach out for sure.
The jaw snaps shut, shattering the glass and swallowing the relic. Eyes beam and stones stir.
May I have that back, please?
From its timeless repose, throwing clouds of dust from wings spread.
Sir?
Wall to wall.
Sir. Okay. He's got first strike, apparently. He is hitting me for 2. I will attempt to block with these and take 2 damage. Obsidian Blade. Wild a spade in your hand into an ace until end of turn. Can be used in a top deck. I guess we should obsidian this 7 into an ace. And then hit him with the 2 aces. That seems like it makes sense to me, at least. Oh, async reaction. But it can also be a reaction. Interesting. And we also have Assassin, so this deals 1 extra damage as well, I believe. And we do win this. And we almost top deck a high enough card for extra damage there, but we don't. We could attack again and try to heal a little bit. I don't hate that.
I'm not done yet.
It's a king. Good chance it wins. Not an amazing chance. It's a draw. Unfortunate. Oh, wait. We only heal off of the other card. Never mind. Okay, 2 kings. We have 2 jacks. I think we will just instead use a... just these 2, probably. Take another 2, unfortunately. I think we once again hit for... oh, no, not what I wanted. Sorry. Just we'll just attack with the 2 jacks. Okay, we do win this. Deal another 3. We could try to attack again, but I think we just save our cards. These don't seem very useful. Okay, two more queens. I don't love that. We just throw these in on the defense here.
Time to strike.
Contract. Heal 3 when the enemy is defeated. Okay, well, I think we got good odds of winning here. So I think we play this. Oh, I guess I just do it like that then? Okay. Oh, I had to apply it to you. Okay, that makes sense. Because we have 2 black cards here. And it's pretty low odds that we lose this. So we come in, attack. Yeah, he does not defend very well. We deal 4 damage, kill. Oh, we deal way more than 4. We deal 8 damage, and we heal some of our HP back. There we go. Oh, thank you, by the way. I will accept my gauntlet, please.
Leave the gauntlet. True.
A bonus.
Leave the gauntlet.
A useful tool.
Leave the gauntlet. It is a pretty baller move to just say no thank you gauntlet. I'm going to do that. This is a more unique effect, I guess, than this. I don't know what overdraw an ability means though. Oh, here we go. What does this mean? It does cost 1 card to play this. Usable items are not discarded after use but can only be used once per round. Allows drawing over your max hand size. You can select excess cards to discard. I don't understand what that means still. Is you keep drawing until you go over your hand size and then it stops when you hit an ability? I'm gonna take this. Let's see what it does.
Of orange light into the room, beckoning you forth.
Okay.
The merchant from the woods sits among his goods in a small antechamber. Before you manage a word,
I've never seen this guy before.
Never mind how I got here. More impressive that you're here, actually. Now, my little branch, about those leaves.
Okay. So, So the way these work, I'm pretty sure if I remember correctly, these are our abilities on our left here. Oh, no, wait, no, wait, no. These are not our abilities. Our abilities are like, yeah, we're going to do this.
Cards.
What? Oh, does that have to be literally cards in our hand here? Oh. Never mind, then. No, thank you.
A narrow footway dares you beyond the door. Lava pumps.
We can heal our HP back, I'm sure.
In the center of a cyclopean cylinder cut into the heart of the mountain. Somehow, the air is cold.
Okay.
3 flickers of heatless flame splash from the lava flow and await you on the platform that skirts the orb.
Are they friendly?
You are not fit to fight, my
They have a lot of HP. They don't love. 4, 5, 7, 9, 10. Life force. What does life force do? I just hit spacebar and skipped my turn. I was hoping that spacebar would maybe show me what like his things did. Okay, we're gonna wild our one of our nines here into a 10. And we're going to block. Yeah, this was a big oopsie for sure. Did not mean to skip my turn by mistake there. Okay, two aces coming in. Let's cancel this one. And then 2 sevens. We do not win this, so we will just give you our 2 worst cards and take 2 damage. Little unfortunate that the space bar does just skip your turn. Was not expecting that. Anyway. We have a full house. Does that count? Because we have... Oh, no, we don't have a full house. We need another 8 or another king to have to be a full house. Never mind. We're going to hit you, though. We're going to hit you with these 2 kings. For sure. We win that easy. 3 damage. And then we're going to... I'm going to discard the queen, I think, for an additional attack. And then we are going to attack you with the 2 eights. That kills one of the flames. That's good. We're going to after images draw 2 cards. Right? And then we're going to Grip of Power. I want to see what this actually does. Oh. That was horrible. Guess we end our turn here. I believe we have lost. Unfortunately. So overdraw just means draw. It does not mean draw until your hand is full. Well. Rip us, we're dead. I will say, spacebar skipping your turn with no checks at all to be like, hey, you sure you want to end your turn here? A little fucked up. A tiny bit fucked up. But oh well, not the end of the world. Retry? I would love to retry that, please, if you don't mind.
Mission accepted.
It would be cool if I got to start back at that fight, but I think they're going to make me start over again. Which is, you know, unfortunate. Yeah. We already saw all this. Kill these bozos. Shank. Win a failed attack of a single card. That's kind of cool. You get the Tallest Arcane out, but this also seems really strong. Just to do that, and then to attack here. Do this instead, right? Get the guaranteed win there. Pitch the 8. Attack with the 9 here. Hopefully it wins. Ooh, just barely. Okay, cool. And we should have this man unbelievably dead with these aces. There you go. Cool.
No technique is forbidden.
Well, I guess we unlock those traits as we level up more.
A blast of sulfur fills the cave with deadly heat.
Yeah, we already... I'm gonna go kill... I gotta go kill that dang old... what's it called?
Pitiful figures shamble from...
Drake or whatever. Top deck against the attacker to cancel combat. Okay, that's kind of neat. I'm not working with much here. I guess we'll just attack with a queen. Okay. Sure, let's throw away a 3. If you get back in with a 9. Okay, there we go. Easy dub. And we will end our turn. Queen. We do not... Oh, wait. How did the top deck work there? Can I see that again? Oh, we top deck versus their top deck, and our number was higher. Okay, I understand. You're coming in with an ace. I have nothing to beat an ace. So we will give you a 2.
You
unfortunate.
To fight my shadow.
We will attempt to contract the dweller here. And if this 9 wins, we do... it does trigger the contract. Okay, cool. We don't heal. Never mind. Illegal. Does not trigger. You know what? Let's go for it. It's a little risky. Let's try to kill. Unfortunate. Maybe next time. 10. We will block with our 10. Could block with the jack and try to use the 10 to get a thirsting fang later. Doesn't seem very worthwhile to me. Block here. Go down to 3. Okay. Let us. Let's attack with the 10. There you go. Easy kill. Now we trigger the contract, heal up to 6, right? And then... Let's just hit him with a jack. Let's hit him with the dual wield first. And then hit him with a jack. That's 2 damage. And we will end our turn. King is unfortunate. If we kill with the 7 here, we get to Thirsting Fang, so let's give it a try. Ooh, lucky us. Thirsting Fang on reaction. And we did the same thing last time. I want to do the exact same thing. Because this seems pretty cool. Yeah. I'm still grabbing this gauntlet every time.
The jaw snaps shut.
For sure. He does come in with 2 kings. Let's attempt a top deck here. We have lost the top deck. Unfortunate. We'll give him... Oh, you know what? We're going to give you a jack here. And we are going to end our turn. Because we can get a straight here potentially, and it'll do so much damage. Oh, I need to use a 3-2. Shit. Okay, that's fine. It's a big risk, but we're going to go for it. Because we have the Thieves Tool to adjust as well. So... 1-2... We're not quite there. So, I've seen poker where aces are both high and low. I don't know if this is the same. Let's just attack with the ace here. Oh, am I not attacking? What's going on? Oh, I'm looking at the wrong unit. Okay, there we go. I'm looking at myself. Okay. We do apparently 4 damage. Cool. Neat. We will end our turn there. Let's attempt to smoke bomb. Oh, we just get to cancel. Okay, cool.
Vanish. I will end this.
Sure. Why not? Our chance at a straight is getting worse and worse as we go. I guess we try to hit with these 2 sixes. We win. We didn't even need the top deck. We still won that anyway. Okay. I will take this, please. So this... Honestly, this was kind of not that impressive because it was just draw an ability. You get rid of one of your cards, you get an ability instead. I'm going to take the level up.
A worthy reward.
Your red cards deal +1 combat damage. So it's just more damage, which I'm perfectly fine with. That seems pretty sick. Okay, note to self. Oh, this guy again. Hello, how's it going? So, I don't mind getting rid of our Thieving's Tool and Thirsting Fang for just like +1 offense here, I think. Obsidian Blade seems very good to me.
A fair price.
So, yeah. And then that's fine.
A narrow footway deck.
Yeah, we saw this. We see the three flickers. Yeah, yeah.
Talon's ready.
So either one of these does a guaranteed 2 damage minimum. And then we can Obsidian Blade for the critical hit, which I think does +3 damage, right? Where is critical hit? You deal double damage. Okay, so it would be 4. Still pretty good. We win the fight. We deal... I will... Oh, it is a... Okay, so I didn't realize this had to be a spade for us to do Obsidian Blade, but we will definitely turn this into an ace for the critical hit. Absolutely. And we can additional attack, which I think we will. And we'll attack with the jacket because we want to leave our spade, or our what is this, club for our smoke bomb. That's unfortunate. And now we're in a bad spot. I mean, we can just block with this instead. And that guy just dies. But now we cancel the attack with a smoke bomb. And the last one comes in with a 7. We can hit with a jack back. Okay.
Talon's ready.
Shuriken, deal 1 attack damage to an enemy. I'd rather just go in with these 2 on you instead. That's a little bit better. We don't need this. It's already like enough for lethal, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, exactly. If we can attack again, we might as well. The queen's a pretty good single attack here, I think. Okay, good draw. Fair. And we will end this turn. They come in with 2 tens. Our best is 2 eights, so we take 2 damage here no matter what. We will block with the 10 and the queen. And we'll attack back with the two eights next turn. And we win. We don't win, actually. No, we do win, because we get the shuriken afterwards. We win. We've done it. But apparently that counts as an attack, too, so it gets all of our random bonuses as well. That's pretty cool. We could level up again here, but we're so low health. I think we just take the restore. Oh, it's a full heal, too. That's pretty nice. Okay. Emanates from deep within the orb and reverberates in your chest. Okay.
You realize that the sphere is a mold now cracking.
Okay. Look, an egg?
The sphere breaks apart in cries of steam. The heat drained from the mountain has been gathered here into one yet hungering form. Eyes gleaming through the mist. It speaks.
Hello. Too soon? What do you mean too soon?
I will end this.
What does your ability do? How long do I have to hover over you for you to show me what your ability does, you son of a bitch? So we can Thieves Tool this king into being an ace and get in a pretty good first hit here, so I like that.
This will be the key.
It's a big hit if this lands. And it does. I guess we shuriken as well. Ooh, that guy got to crit as well, so we get 4 damage there. We could try to go crazy and dual wheel here. It doesn't seem very useful to me. Our opponent gets to hit us for 2. We will accept that. I'm okay with you hitting me for 2.
You are not fit to fight my shadow.
We can just smoke bomb next turn, which is pretty sick. I think we go. Oh, the siphon heals you. Ooh, okay, that's good to know. Let's just attack with an ace. We win this. Nice. You love to see it. Crit for 4. And then we go for a second attack here, I'm pretty sure. And hope that our queen gets through. It does. We win. GG. Very cool.
The ligaments of light between the armor dim and the swirling smoke loses its purpose as the helmet comes to a clattering stop. Ringed eyes fade, beholding you as their final act.
Okay, bye-bye.
Stairs spiral around the center spire, vanishing.
That seems like it was the final boss, right? I think we finished the campaign or whatever.
High atop the shaft. Hours later, the stairs bring you to a passage filled with a sand of pulverized obsidian. Beyond lies a sea of black dunes.
Okay.
Beneath a cerulean sky.
Now, I'll be honest. I thought this word was cerulean. They said cerulean. Can I get a word check? Not to be too critical. I'm just curious for myself now. If I've been saying that word right or wrong this whole time. We have won. I'm not saying that we definitely would have won that on the first attempt if I didn't skip my first round against the Triple Flames. But I do think that it's fair to say that that was a big issue. First completion, complete the Womb of Flame adventure with Shay Lin for the first time. Okay.
Contract fulfilled.
Much faster than the previous run, although I guess in the previous run, I was still learning the game a bit more. So that's fair. Is A rank the highest or is it S rank is the highest, by the way? Also, get me out of here. Hello? Oh, there we go. We're done. Cool, cool, cool. We fill up our magic little vial there. Oh, coconut. What do we got in here? Ooh. Okay, so we've got an epic or a legendary. We got a rare. Is this the same? Why? Oh, these are for the characters. See, these are warriors. These are warrior cards. These are rogue cards. Okay. Grapple shield, whatever, blood and steel. You'll double attack damage on a flush. That seems pretty pretty uncommon, but whatever. Broad axe block. Gain 2 shields, draw a card. Okay, it's neat. And our rare here. Oh, that's pretty cool. And our legendary, contract +1. Draw an ability and heal 3 HP when the enemy is defeated. Okay, that's cool. The problem with that is that a lot of fights, oftentimes like bosses and stuff, only have one guy. Although I guess your cards do hold over to the next combat and stuff like that, so this is kind of cool. Okay. More magic juice, okay.
Lost in a sea of sand, a lithe tree grows from the memory of a sage that rests here. Long did he journey for truth to save man. And on the last page of the last book he ever lifted, found that the only thing which keeps man walking is hope.
Who asked?
And the only thing that can kill it is knowing.
What are you talking about? I've unlocked Nazim the Mage. That's pretty cool. Okay. Well, I guess next episode we're gonna be checking out the Mage's deck. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.